Hey guys, before we get into it, I just want to thank the sponsor of this video, Gothic. As you probably already know, Gothic is one of my favorite jewelry companies to work with. They've always made sure to send me some of the best looking handmade pieces you can find without sacrificing quality. They have a huge collection of products that range from rings, pendants, bracelets, and earrings that all come in a variety of different materials and styles. Every design has its own unique look, making it easy for anyone to find something they'd like. So if you're interested at all in Gothic, then be sure to check out the link down below in the description and get 20% off using discount code NICK20. Tears the best. Today we're going to be checking out Bullet for My Valentine, Tears Don't Fall Part 2. Now, obviously, you know, I know the first one. I think everybody knows the first one. It's a classic. You know, little young emo Nick always jamming that good track. Old Bullet was enjoyable, right? Then I kind of, you know, lost touch of them when they released Temper Temper. I think I heard like one track from this album and I was like, no. So I always knew Tears Don't Fall Part 2 existed, but I never checked it out for some reason. So that's what we're doing today. All right, sure, check out some Nick Knock merch. Spotify playlist, all the bangers are there. And I'll be streaming on Twitch right after this video is uploaded today. Twitch.tv/NickNocturnal. Link in the description below. Let's go. I'm excited. Please don't suck. Some feedback noises. Okay. Huh? Of course. Let's go again. That's weird. It's like an alternate universe of the original so far.
10,000 times. I've tried to call you. I know you wanna talk. I need to show you how I hurt. So answer me.
Okay.
Talk to me. So answer me. Where's your sympathy?
Yeah, pour your salt into my wounds
and make me feel like I'm to blame.
Okay.
Is my possession. Obsession.
It's something.
Your final breath is now my possession.
10,000
times.
It's so similar, but it's so not. What? Chuggers.
Talk to me. So answer me. Where's your empathy?
Yeah, pour your salt into my wounds
and make me feel like
some angsty. Don't know about the chorus. Like the first one, speeding up now.
Making me feel like I'm to blame. Keep pouring salt into my wounds. Keep making me feel like I'm to blame. Keep pouring salt into my wounds.
Amping. Whoa. What is happening? Sound like video game for a second. Damn. Harmonies for days. Nice yell. Back into it. Okay. The pre-chorus is really good. Okay. Some chorus 2.0. Back to the bird noises. That it? That was 5.5 minutes? Oh my god, what? okay. Wow. It's weirdly what I expected and nothing of what I have expected. Let's get into it. So, I guess before even just like talking about everything individually, yeah, it's so similar to the first one. Even like structurally, it's similar to the first one. Even chord progression, it's similar to the first one. But it's just an alternate universe version of it. Guitar work, I mean, it's Bullet. Like the funnest part about guitar work from Bullet is always, it's kind of less is more. Right, they still have the riffs, a lot of harmonies, a lot of metalcore, you know, stereotypical things. And they do it in such like a nice, catchy, fun way, you know. They always do it well, but it's not super techy by any means. The guitar solo was pretty crazy. I actually like the guitar solo in this version better than I'd say the original. Everything else though, no. But the guitar solo I actually really liked in this version. I thought it was cool. Drums, same kind of thing, you know. Takes a step back, but still has a few of those like metalcore stereotypical, you know, drum things in general. A lot of fun kick work, but simple, you know, nothing super crazy. And bass, same thing. Vocals, you know, Matt is very iconic with his voice. I feel like if you just had this instrumental without Matt, just like any Bullet song, to be honest, it would feel so kind of bland. His voice really, really makes it. He had good melodies. I liked where he threw some angst in as well. I would have liked a little more angst here and there. But, you know, whatever. The emo vibes were there. That's fine. Pre-chorus was dope. The chorus. It's not a bad chorus. But it's not my favorite. It feels very simple. It feels like it's almost trying literally to mimic the first one, and then they just took a shift for that chorus. They're like, well, how do we make something as hooky but different enough so we can call it different? And this just feels like a much weaker Tears Don't Fall chorus. That's really it. It's not bad. It's because, I mean, the original Tears Don't Fall chorus, is that's the whole song is that chorus. But, you know, it's decent. It gets the song going. Audio overall. So I will say this. This was better than I thought it was going to be. You know, people not really always talking about Tears Don't Fall Part 2. They're just like, well, there's the first one. Obviously, that one's legendary by now. Like, they don't really mention the second one much. I mean, Bullet is a band, again, I grew up with it. I grew up with that old stuff. I love that stuff. I'd give this like a 3.5. Like, again, I don't think it's bad by any means. I see why it's not as popular, obviously, as the first one. But, you know, I think it was a cool alternative demo take on it. Truly it. It was a cool experience. I'm glad I got to listen to it, at least. It's kind of my point. Like 3.1 by 3.75 even, you know. It's not bad. It's not bad by any means. It's cool. Decent. But saying part two right there, and you can't compare it to that first one. The first one, it can't. Yeah, anyways, guys, let me know your thoughts down below. Original songs down there, too. Check it out if you want. Yeah, let me know your thoughts. Is there other, you know, Bullet songs that from this album that, you know, like I literally only checked out probably one song when it came out. Let me know if there's any other, like, undiscovered or less known Bullet songs that maybe I haven't checked out. Or in general, let me know what else I should react to, like old school metalcore stuff. Because there's always these uncovered, you know, gems that I like finding. So let me know. And yeah, guys, be sure to check out Gothic again. They're awesome. Link to them is down below in the description. I work with them all the time. You already know the gist. Show them the love, okay? And yeah, I want to give a special thing. Oh, wait, merch and Spotify banger playlist. And I'll be streaming on Twitch right after this video is uploaded today. Twitch.tv/Nathan, link in the description below. And I want to give a special thanks to a few of my patrons. Thank you guys so much for support. Really, really appreciate it. If you suffer interested with a Patreon, connect a bunch of cool perks, top tracks, so much more. It's going to be in the description down below. If you watch more videos, make sure to click right over here. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.